Hi everyone, this is Real World Audio and I have something truly special today, and I'm going to show you that it is possible to have a truly exceptional turntable for very little money. And this is my trusted old Rega table, and as you've seen, it's quite highly modified. So it has gone from a very basic status, which is like a P3 table. I would say it's even the basic P3 table is a pretty decent table, and I would say that is where good sound begins. So if you are totally new to turntables and you are getting into vinyl, and you want to buy your first table, then I would say look up a used Rega Planar 3 or P3, and that one will give you a standard of sound, which is I would say, which is really something that you would like to have. And above this sound, it's really, I would say, the truly musical world. And below the Rega P3, you can still have good deals, good values, but there you have a lot of the weaknesses that come with more basic tables. But I won't talk about that. I will leave that to another video. Here in this video, I will show you the basic things I have done to my Rega, and I will also tell you how far did these modifications take this table. So the number one thing is that you need an isolation platform for it. And I've been using, so basically it's really simple. You have a wooden frame and you fill it up with sand and put a wooden plate on it. And then you put your turntable on it. And that will result in a very nice isolation. You can also use other kinds of isolation platform, but this is something that's like really simple to build. You really need like four pieces of wood. You need a bottom, you need sand and another piece of wood. And if you want to improve on it, then just have like only a small layer of sand and put tennis balls on it. And on top, you can put a heavy, maybe like a stone block. And then you can put your table onto that stone block, and then you will have a truly an air table. And this air table thing or sand table will elevate your Rega's sound a lot, so much that it will be really hard for you to recognize that it's still the same table. Even with those modifications, it will still have the problem of some motor noise and rumble, and also the weaknesses from the glass splatter. And you can highly improve on that by, I'm taking off the platter, and you see I've added cork, like pieces of cork glued on it. So you see that if it's not like a perfect circle with like a weight distribution to the microgram in every direction, it doesn't matter at all. Just cover the thing as well as you can. It will be fine. And also on top of that, I made an extra piece of cork and put it here on the support. And here, that's the motor, and the motor in the Rega normally it's suspended to the chassis, and there is the cats are hungry. Kintaro, wait for your meal. Wait for your dinner, Kintaro. So here the motor is normally suspended to the chassis, but I've taken it off the chassis, and instead it has its own bed that it's sitting on. It's connected to the table. It's sitting on a table and doesn't make any contact with the plinth of the turntable. And it's super duper extremely quiet, and even with like super efficient speakers, you do not have not even a hint of a motor rumble or any kind of noise. Also, you can jump if you want, or dance, do whatever. The table will prevent the vibrations to going to the platter, and you won't have any such silly issues like that. And of course, I have shown my long wooden tone arm. You don't need, if you do not have that much space, you can use a regular size arm. So actually, with this arm I made by copying the dimensions of the Rega RB300 arm, and I made it out of wood. So this is what I've been using. This was my very first wooden tone arm, and I made a base for it, and the bearing that it uses, that is an arrowhead. So I used an arrowhead. And for the wiring, the tone arm wiring, it's a gauge 34 copper magnet wire, two wires twisted per channel for positive and negative, and then it goes to the RCA jacks, and that's it. And here it has a small bands cartridge, the H2O. And this combination is truly something really stellar. And for the tone arm, it's totally manual. There's no cueing device, no nothing fancy to it. So you just manually lift it, put it on the record, and when it's done, you lift it, put it back. That's it. And how good is this wooden arm? I would say it's better than any metal arm I have compared it against. Sure, some really high-end metal arms give you greater detail, better pinpoint resolution, but all of them give you much poorer harmonic content. So if you want to listen to cello, you want to listen to human voice, you will be very, very hard to press to find a commercial tone arm that can provide a comparable experience. So of course, it's really up to your tastes, because if you like a really clinical and very sterile presentation, this table will not give you that. But if you want to experience, let's say, a cello, or as I said, human voice or a piano, this will bring you music and joy in your life. And really, use the Rega, small Rega table can be bought really easily for a pretty decent prices, especially if you buy one without the arm. You can build this arm. I built this arm probably how much? It was the cost of a pair of RCA jacks, which is next to nothing. A piece of wood. You probably have something in your shed. You can use it if you want. Or if you can want to go all out, get some tone wood grade spruce. It probably will set you back maybe like $10 for this piece. And you will need a few brass screws for counterbalance. That will probably cost a few dollars. Kintaro, wait for your food, please wait. Okay, so I think the cats are getting really hungry, and it's time for feeding, and also it's time for you to just think about how you want to take your turntable in which direction. Of course, building a wooden arm is more of a challenge, but believe me, it's well worth it. And if you are not in a position to pay thousands of dollars for a high quality tone arm, then maybe a couple of your weekends and a trip to Home Depot, City Mill, or Obi, or whatever you have in your neighborhood, it's not really the end of the world to ask. And of course, using a little bit of cork and getting a few kilos of sand or a few pounds of sand and a box underneath, that's also a no-brainer. And I can just tell you guys that this table as it is, it when I compared it to a Rega P9, it, well, I would say it did not completely spunk the P9, because the P9 was equipped with a cartridge that was a truly high-end cartridge, and I, at that time when I did the comparison, used a very basic Audio-Technica cartridge on this table, but they played at the same level, so imagine that. So if you do not have money for the top Rega table or another high quality turntable, then you can take your basic turntable to that level by following these few simple tricks. Thank you for tuning in. It's time to feed the cats. Bye bye.